The British Medical Association, the BMA, voted at its annual representative meeting this year in June to support the complete decriminalisation of abortion. So, in other words, to make abortion legal effectively right up to birth for any and every reason. There are 175,000 doctors in the BMA, but this vote was carried by between 150 and 180 representatives at the annual meeting who voted on its various parts. So about 0.1% or a thousandth of the whole membership. The BMA is a trade union of doctors. It's a pressure group. So they can't change the law or change practice, but they are very influential. Earlier this year, Diana Johnson, who's an MP, brought a 10-minute rule bill to Parliament attempting to do just the same thing, completely decriminalise abortion. And it actually passed by a very slim majority, but ran out of parliamentary time. And the thought is now that the BMA have done this, it would be very likely for someone to try something else like the Johnson bill. However, there are other possibilities, and there are two health-related bills that were in the Queen's speech that people could well attempt to put an amendment on to the same effect. If you have a private member's bill, then you know some weeks before what you're up against and can plan a good defence. If it's an amendment attached to another government bill, there might only be days warning, which is why it's incredibly important that MPs are well briefed of this ahead of time. With the Johnson bill earlier in the year, there were a very large number of Tory MPs who didn't vote either way, and I think they were just unsure about where they stood. So we cannot have that situation where people just don't understand what they're passing. The snap election hasn't helped the pro-life side, and probably between 20 and 30 pro-life MPs were lost, including Rob Flallow from the Labour Party and David Burrows from the Tories. With a finely balanced parliament, it is a very delicate situation, which is why it's so important that people are praying and that parliamentarians are well briefed and prepared. We're confident that if people understand fully the implications of what decriminalisation would mean, both for women and babies, they will vote against it. But if it's sprung upon them as an amendment to a government bill without them being properly prepared, the danger is that they could be like rabbits in the headlights and not know what to do.